Okay, part three. Last time you did a cleanup of your home screens, your icons, and your focus modes. And then we created you two new focus modes, one for work, one for offline, and a couple of home screens to go with them so it's visually obvious which focus mode you're in. So in this video, we're going to jump into the Shortcuts app because this is what we're going to use as our like command center for this sort of stuff. I think of it as like you're there in the middle and you can pull multiple levers and you can get it to do things, multiple actions for you at once. Because as soon as you want to change more than one thing at once, and we are going to change our focus mode and the timery, see the diagrams in the previous video, you're going to want a shortcut. So the shortcut serves as the hub. We activate one thing and then it goes out and does various actions for us. And that also gives us the ability to change that workflow really easily without changing the thing that we trigger, which will make sense in a bit. Now, shortcuts, I appreciate that it exists and I appreciate what it does, but it's a little bit weird. So I'll point out some of the weirdnesses when we get to them, but just bear with it and just run through this in sequence and I'll guide you through this. So the first thing we're going to do in Shortcuts is put all of our stuff in its own folder because it Shortcuts comes with a bunch of default shortcuts and we're just going to keep our stuff in a neat place. So make sure you have got all shortcuts selected on the left-hand side there and then just do File, New Folder, call it whatever you want, and you can give it a new icon like this. Okay, now let's create a new shortcut. We're going to cover the simplest one first, which is offline mode, because there's no choice for us to make here. We're just doing two things. We're changing to our offline focus mode, and we're activating our offline timer. So over here on the right-hand side is where we select from the possible actions. So actions, your shortcut is built of actions in sequence. So the first one is the set focus action. So select that from the list of actions on the right-hand side, and then drag it into this main area here. Now you can see that we've got some options to choose from here. This one's pretty intuitive, but with something like this, it's funny, people always ask us computer people, like, how are you so good at computers? And the answer is, people like me, we just click all the options. We just try everything, right? It's like, what's this? What's this? What's this? And so I think it's always worth having a little click around so you get a feel for the thing. So for this particular action, what we can do is we can turn a mode on or off, or we can toggle a mode, which will turn it on if it's already on and off if it's off, or the other way around, you know what I mean? Like a light switch, on, off. In this particular case, because we don't know what mode we're going to be in when we activate the shortcut, we don't want the toggle. We just want a simple action to turn offline mode on until it's turned off, which means it won't turn itself off at some point in time. Okay, so there's your first little action. Hope that's, and it's quite nice, right? Reads like English, it's obvious enough. Now you can test this already. I'm gonna hold my phone up. I'm just gonna run that shortcut. And of course, because focus modes synchronize across all of your devices, soon enough. Sometimes that happens instantly, sometimes it takes about 20 seconds, but eventually, that will work, right? So there's your first action, nice and simple. Okay, next we need to head to Timery because this whole thing works by starting saved timers. That's what it does. The action in Shortcuts starts a saved timer from Timery. So first we need to set up those saved timers, and we do that over in Timery. So go to Save Timers and add one using the plus and give it whatever details you want. Personally, I just use project and description. I don't use tags. And here's how my projects are configured. They mirror my Johnny.Decimal systems. So I've got two for Johnny.Decimal. One is me updating the website, and one is me working on the business. And personally, I've got one that covers most of my personal life, including that broad untracked time concept and my fitness. And the other one, I've got another project specifically for when I'm offline. And that's because the colors stand out in the various summary views of Timery, like this one. And I just like being able to differentiate the kind of gray offline time from green personal time. And that's why it's gray, not red, because I didn't want this to stand out. For me, gray is just, I kind of just want it to fade away. I just don't want to see it. So back to our save timer. This one is our offline project, and the description is offline, and you can chuck some emoji in there just to make it a bit more interesting. And once you've got a few save timers, you can keep this list neat by reordering things. You click the little arrows at the top, and then you can just drag things around. So I keep them nice and neat. Okay, back to shortcuts now. So what we're going to do is build this action to start one of these save timers. So the action we want is start save timer, which is fairly obvious in this case. It's not always that obvious. If you want to browse the actions for an app as opposed to trying to work out what to search for, you can just choose the apps tab and then pick the app, and it'll just show you all the things it can do. So what we're going to do is drag over the start save timer action, and you can see this is kind of dimmed out like it wants us to choose something. And sure enough, if we click it, it's going to show us a list of our saved timers, and we choose the offline timer that we just created. Worth noting that this action has a show more option. It's always worth a look at these show more things. See previous comment about clicking all the buttons. And in this case, this show when run thing, whenever we see that on, it's on by default, we're always going to turn it off because it's not useful to us in this case. What it does is it puts up like a notification on screen, and we just don't need it. Okay, let's test that. So look at that. One click and we've got two actions. The focus mode activates and the timer starts. It's very nice. Before we leave this window, what we're going to do is give this thing an icon and a color and a proper name, which we do up in the toolbar here. And this is one of those things about shortcuts that I think is a bit like, it's not, I wish that just looked like an input field. It's not very obvious that that's a thing you can change, but hey, now you know. So before you set up all of your work timers, I'm just going to show you one of the benefits of this being a shortcut versus just activating two things yourself manually, because you might be thinking this is a bit of a faff on, which it is. So in shortcuts on your phone, find the new shortcut and click the three dots to edit. And just a quick note, it took me ages to get out of the habit of the shortcuts app assumes you want to be in there running a shortcut. So when you tap on a shortcut, it runs the shortcut. I kind of instinctively assume it will take me into the details of the shortcut, which it doesn't. For that, you need the three dots, so just be aware of that. So tap the three dots and then the share sheet icon down here, and then one of the options here is to add to home screen. So do that, confirm the icon, click add, and look at that. You've made your own little app essentially on your home screen. And this is what I mean. Now, when you modify the shortcut by adding more actions to it, you don't have to change this icon. This icon refers to the shortcut, and you can change the shortcut to do anything you want. It's really handy. These things are also available from Spotlight. So if you're on another device, home screens don't synchronize, unfortunately. So what you can do, you can just drag down on your home screen and you get the search, and you can type in the name of the shortcut and that'll be found in search, and you can just run it directly from there. Theoretically, they're also available from the Apple voice assistant, whose name I won't say because I always activate it and that annoys Lucy. But I've got a HomePod in this room, and theoretically I could say, hey Dingus, and say the name of one of my shortcuts. I tried it earlier and it didn't actually work. But I have tried that before and it does work. So just FYI, that's a thing you should be able to do. Okay, back to Timery. Let's get you a few work timers set up, because these are the things that you're going to start when you start work. So we need to know what your work is. Configure those yourself in Timery. Pause me now if you haven't already done that, and unpause when you have. Okay, this is a multi-step process in shortcuts, and it's a little bit complicated, but just follow along. Unlike the last time with the offline timer, we hard-coded is the term we use. We hard-coded the name of the timer that we wanted to start into the shortcut, because it was always the offline timer. This time, what we want to do is go and get your work timers and show you a list of them so you can choose which one to start. And then we'll start the one that the user, you, selected. So the first action in this sequence is to find saved timers. By default, this will show all of our saved timers, which we can see if we run it. In this output box below the action, it's showing us the results of the action. If you click the middle icon to switch to this view, it's a bit more obvious what it's doing, and we can see that it did in fact get all of our saved timers. We can filter based on criteria, which is really handy in this situation, because when we start work, there's no point showing us our home and offline timers. We might as well be focused on just the work stuff. So let's add a filter, and we want project contains. And this is one of the nice little things about the JD system, having a unique system identifier. You can just type that in there and you don't have to type the whole name of the project. Note the difference between project is and project contains. Project is needs an exact match, whereas project contains is a bit like a search within the project. So that just makes life a bit easier. So let's run that. And now in the results, we can just see our work projects. Brilliant. Okay, so now we need to do something with this. What we need to do is to choose one of these things from the list. And there's an action called choose from list. So let's drag that in. Now this gets interesting, and this is where you become a bit of a computer programmer, because you're about to deal with variables, because the choose from action needs a list of things to choose from. And what we want to choose from is the save timers that we just had from the action above. And there's a really nice feature of shortcuts where it understands what each of these blocks output, and it makes them available as what it calls magic variables to you. And by default, the choose from list thing has already grabbed the output of the action from above. You can see it already says choose from save timers. And there's a tiny line joining those two blocks. But just to make it explicit what's happening, let's erase this. So I'm going to click on save timers in there and clear that. And we're going to set it up manually again. So now you can see choose from, you'll see those two action blocks are now not linked anymore. Choose from, and the list is kind of gray as if it wants us to choose something. So click on that. And we can do two things. We can either click select variable at the top, the thing with a magic wand, or at the bottom of this list, it knows about the variables around here that it could use. And so it's telling us that saved timers is the thing that we can use. But let's not do that. Let's click select variable. And you can see that there are two things to choose from. We've got the shortcut input at the top of this window, and then we've got the save timers as the output of this action block. And so hopefully it's obvious which one we want. We want saved timers. And again, just think about how these things work. We start at the top and we just go through in sequence. So at the top here, shortcut input, I presume is blank because I haven't given it anything. And so there'd be no point selecting that. But then after we have found save timers, we've got a save timers variable. So choose that one. And there we go. So now let's run that, and now we get presented the list, and we can choose an item from the list, and now we can see the output of the choose from list is the one we chose from the list. Okay, one more step. For the final action, we need to start the saved timer that we've chosen. So start saved timer is the action. We drag that in below choose from save timers, and again you can see that it's chosen the magic variable from above. It's going to start the chosen item. I'm not going to clear that one out and show you, because it should be obvious we're finding all save timers, and in fact go from the very top, we're turning on a focus mode, and that action is standalone. It doesn't feed its information to anything else. There are no lines coming out of it going anywhere else. Then we find save timers with a filter criteria. We feed that to a choose from list, and we feed the output of the choose from list to a start timer. And that's all linked by little dashes. So if we do that now, if we run that, we should see we get presented a list of things. You can choose one of them. Okay, and that starts in Timery. And there we go. One last thing. Don't forget to show more and turn off show when run, because we don't need those notifications that we get. All right, that was a lot. That's mostly it. Let's not forget to give this thing a name and an icon at the top there. And now we can add it to our home screens like before if you want to. Just a thought here. What I would do, I would probably, if I was you now, just delete this save timer. Just delete it and start again. Try and do it again without watching the video, just to really get used to this. You're not going to have to update this much, but it does help if you have an understanding of what this thing's doing. One more benefit of this being a shortcut, and then that'll do for now. So on your Mac, if you drag any of your shortcuts onto this menu bar item in the sidebar here, you'll get an icon in your menu bar which lets you run any of those shortcuts just right there. And that's how I do it on my Mac. Okay, that's it. Thanks for paying attention. Hope your brain's nice and hot. Next time, I'd like to see you having your saved timers up and working. And I'll see you then.